The title of this painting is Ugolino Number One. Now, when you first look at this, it may not look like a golf course, but when you begin to look closely, you can see over in the left, upper left, middle left-hand corner are some little sand traps hiding in the trees. This is actually the first hole of the Ugolino Golf Club, which is right outside of the city of Florence. And I began going there at the invitation of a friend in 2004 when we were, Susan and I were first leasing our apartment on Borgo d'Abruzzi. And this is the first painting I did, but it started a love affair that I had with the golf course for over 15 years. As it turned out, this is the first painting I did. I ended up doing another 14 from various locations on the course. I would like to just read something that I had sent to Sister Wendy Beckett when we had begun corresponding back in, as I mentioned, early 2002. And when I had sent her some photos of paintings that I had done from Ugolino, my comment was, I was really amazed at the beautiful landscape of the Ugolino golf course in Florence. I was invited to play there by a Florentine friend, and I couldn't believe the vistas, the cypress trees, olive trees, hills, small valleys. It is a remarkable and stunning place, and as beautiful as any I have seen in this region. And that was my thoughts after doing a couple of paintings there. And it turned out, with all the years that we did spend in Chianti and Tuscany, it was very difficult to actually top these vistas. Now, just getting back to the first one, this is actually in the foreground here is the first tee where you would hit the golf ball, and over to the right is where the people that played there would instruct you to hit it, because if you didn't, the ball would start rolling down into these valleys on the left, which go behind that little mound which is separating the first tee from the rest of the fairway. But at any rate, these colors, this was in the autumn, and it was just a spectacular day. And I didn't have my sketchbook with me when I was playing, but I always have a little camera. So I took a camera with me that day, and I was taking photos as we were playing. And it sort of takes away from your game when you are photographing everything. But I was just, you know, I've played golf pretty much back and forth in my life since I was in my early 20s. But I was stunned by the beauty of this entire golf course. And again, it was maybe 15, 20 minutes from Florence. So I went back to my studio. My friend's name is Corso Flaccomio, actually. And that fall, I worked on this painting. And it's pretty big. It's 60 by 72. And around November, Corso had come to my studio, which was actually at the time my new studio, which was on the top floor of an old building right at the end of the Ponte Vecchio, right on the river. And I had beautiful light there, although the studio itself wasn't all that big. So I was doing this painting, and then Corso came up with an idea that I should donate this to the golf club. And at the time, I was a little reluctant to do that. I mean, I had a fairly good client base, and paintings of this size I was selling, you know, anywhere from $20,000 to $25,000. So my idea of donating it, or Corso's idea of donating it, didn't really strike me as something I was interested in doing. But he's a very nice Florentine, and he said, "You must hear me out." And he said, "I have a plan. If we donate this and they accept it," and at this point I'm starting to get a little I wouldn't say uptight, but I, you know, maybe a little angry. What do you mean if they accept it? And he said, well, you have to understand, you know, it's Florence. You're not, not only you're not Florentine, you're not even Italian. And I think to get this painting in the golf club would be very prestigious for you. Because, in fact, it was one of the oldest and most prestigious golf clubs in the entire country of Italy. So he said, let's just start with that. And then I said, would they exchange it for a membership? And he said, no, they would not do that. But we may be able to work out a plan, another plan. So at any rate, I actually did meet with the board of the directors of the golf club, and they were very nice. Very polished, very nice, not the most open, sort of reserved, I guess is the best word. But they checked me out. At the time, we did have a pretty decent website, and then they realized that I did, in fact, have a pretty sophisticated client base and was also the subject of some very strong and powerful, nice art critics' statements about my work. So they went ahead and they voted to accept it. And then Corso and I met with the director of golf, our friend Fausto, and we made a little deal that now that the painting was in there, that I would get a little card that allowed me to play several rounds of golf. And that was just our little secret. So anyway, in December, we went up. We had, it's another interesting thing to show how great I think the Florentine people are in the whole business of art, the framing and the hanging and everything. As I said, my studio was on the fourth floor, and it was a walk-up of an old building on the Ponte Vecchio. Now, this painting, at the time, it was exactly 150 by 180 centimeters, which means it's about 5 by 6 feet. So Corso knew this framing company, and they came. Actually, didn't come. I just brought the measurements to them, and actually, we brought the painting. Brought the painting, and then they framed it. And they actually hand-delivered it to my studio, walking up the stairs. And then we had it delivered to the golf course. And that was in December of 2005. And again, it was the very first painting that I did from the golf course. And it was the beginning of a happy little affair for me, both in the time I played there and in the subsequent 14 paintings that I did. I would like to add that in addition to the original 60 by 72 inch painting of Ugolino, which is now proudly hanging at the golf club, I also painted two other versions. One was a 24 by 32 inch, which is in the collection of Charlie and Cheryl Noble in Sarasota, Florida. And the third one was a 20 by 24 version, which Susan and I gave to Sister Wendy for her a belated birthday present when she came to our studio in Florence in 2006. And the following is a little video clip of the presentation that we gave it to her, because one of her comments after I had sent her the paintings was that she just loved the Ugolino pictures. They were ravishingly lovely, among your best, which is high praise, is what she said. So we rewarded her with this for her birthday. Thank you.
Go.
Bonatali, Sister Wendy. Bonatali,
okay. Oh, good. Got the kiss. Very good.